Hey guys, it's Amanda. Welcome back to my channel. Today I have a full apartment tour for you guys. As you guys may or may not know, I have officially moved into New York City to start my first job as a veterinarian. I just wanted to give you guys a look at my studio apartment. God knows that I was YouTubing all the apartment tours possible in order to see what would fit, what wouldn't fit, how to best decorate, how to get things for cheap. I went into this already knowing a studio apartment was going to be very small, so I wanted to make the space mainly for me. At the same time, I did have to make it, you know, accommodating for me and two pets, considering I have Django and Harith. So I think I did a really good job of that, and I'm so excited to show you guys. Alright guys, so right when you step in to the left, I have this cubby shelf unit that I got from IKEA. And on top of that, I have my little key holder. This is from India. And then moving into this shelving space, I just have two little holders. I think they're from Pier 1 Imports, that I just have my headphones and some chapstick, and then I have my watches and my sunglasses. And then right next to my bed, I have this little table. This is also from IKEA, and I just have a tissue box holder from Amazon and a lotion container thingamabobber from Walmart, and just a picture of my mom. And then when you go down here, I just have some miscellaneous things. So I have a bunch of books, and then next to my bed, I just have some water, and I have like Advil, Icy Hot, my Zyrtec, and then lint removers. And here I have a box for all of Django's like stuff to go on a walk. So his leashes, some wipes to wipe his paws off, trash bags, his muzzle, things like that. All of these little cork mats, I have a few placed throughout the apartment. They're from the Christmas tree shop. And these fabric boxes are all from Wayfair. I think I got like a 6-pack of them. So behind me is the door, and I have a set of wall hooks right here. The second I come in, I just want to take what I have that might be dirty or contaminated or something and put it right near the entryway. That's also why I have my shoe rack right near the entrance. I like to take my shoes off outside of the door and then carry them in and place them right onto the shoe rack. Again, because I work at an animal hospital, I don't want to be bringing in anything dirty. This shoe rack is from Amazon, by the way. It's pretty functional, very decently priced, so I mean, it does the job and I clearly need it. I have a coat rack that I also got from Amazon that you can see I keep it at like stomach level just because I don't want it to be tall enough that it makes it look like it's taking up too much of my wall space. And then right below that, I have some storage space where I have Django's little toy box that you can see he takes his toys out of when he wants to. And that toy box is from Amazon as well. As far as wall decor, I have these wall shelves that I got from Amazon. So up there I have this Buddha statue that I actually got from India. Next to that, this little fake plant from IKEA, and then just a framed picture of my brother and I just have that above this coat rack. While we're here, let me show you all of these rugs I have. So I have three rugs. I have this one light gray one. It's in a rectangular shape. This is from the Christmas tree shop. I got it on sale. Guys, $20. And then I have a large circular rug. This is from IKEA. And then I have a smaller circular rug, also from IKEA. Having rugs has been such a huge difference for me living on wooden floor. The pets love it, so really happy with these two purchases. And now that we're here, let's just move into the seating area. So this wonderful comfy armchair is from IKEA also. Got it at a super decent price. And then I also got this pillow from IKEA as well with the cover on it. This side table is something that I bought almost 3 years ago. It's from Wayfair.com and it actually came in a pack of two. It's been holding on for 3 years now and it was so cheap, so I'm really happy I bought it. It did come with these weird plastic gray colored legs that I just spray painted it dark brown. I have this little dog decor that I got from Home Goods, some books I'm reading, this candle from Walmart. I have this basket from Walmart. I don't know if you can see, but it is great quality and I can't believe I got it from Walmart. And then this beautiful picture my brother got me as a gift, as like part of the graduation gift, and it's Norman Rockwell's illustration called At the Vets, and
I mean, it just means so much to me because my brother and I had this huge book of Norman Rockwell illustrations and we would go through it every single day. Best gift ever.
Speaking of my brother being the best gift giver, this is the first gift he got me when I got into vet school, like an actual knit artwork piece of a bat dissection. So kind of apt for the fact that I was going into anatomy. And then behind that, behind the sofa, I have a woven stand of some sort. This is actually really old. It was in my basement. And then this giraffe statue is from Pier 1 Imports. Let's move right into the bedroom. So to give you perspective, the bed is literally right next to the door. This is a Django. Django, get down, please. Thank you. Hi, Bubba. And he has a do not pet collar on because this is New York and I trust no one. So we're just trying to be safe, right? But do not pet me. Anyway, the sheets I got from Amazon, of course. They're beautiful white sheets. These green pillows I'm pretty sure are from TJ Maxx. I could be wrong. And then this white fluffy pillow is from Home Goods. These are things I've had for years now, so it's not like I bought them new. I bought a new bed frame, which I absolutely love. This is a wooden frame from Amazon. Oh my goodness, so affordable. We'll leave it in the description box down below. It is sturdy, so very happy with that purchase. And then, as you can see, Django's trying to get into his crate. This is actually perfect for me in the studio apartment. I put his crate right next to the bed. He goes in it. I'll probably have him in there when I go to work and stuff, but to make it a little bit more aesthetically pleasing, I actually put some marble contact paper on top of cardboard. That's literally all this is. And then now I'm able to use it as another table. So I have this woven basket and a Keep Calm and Bark On pillow behind it. And then in front of the bed, I just have Harrod's cat scratch thing, obviously, and then this beautiful ottoman. Again, several years old, I got it from Wayfair, and it has storage space underneath that I put notes in, extra blankets in, but it's also perfect for sitting, and Django uses it to climb on top, Harrod sleeps on it.
This bed, let me tell you, is the comfiest bed I've ever slept in. This is a queen-sized Lull mattress that Lull actually sent to me, so I'm very thankful for that. I feel like having this is finally the luxury that I needed. This has like three layers of foam on top, so it's so comfortable while still staying firm, so it doesn't kind of like just sink in. It molds to your body but keeps your back straight, and for me that has been so important, and I've noticed such a change. I mentioned it before, it was years ago, but I was hit by a car when I was walking. Since then I've been having this kind of recurrent back pain, especially when my positioning is wrong. It flares up so badly. This has made such a huge difference for me. I mean, that's not the case for everyone, but in the other sense, just having a tiring, busy day, knowing that I have a few hours to sleep and I need to make sure that that sleep is perfect. I sleep through the night in this. Having a dog, Django jumps on and off. He like does that thing where he stands up, makes circles, and then sits back down, and that used to wake me up in the night all the time, and that has completely stopped. Like, I go to sleep and I don't wake up until morning, and it has been so amazing. And if that didn't make it perfect enough, it also is so easy to kind of unwrap and put on. So it comes up wrapped in a box in a roll, and all you do is slit open the packaging, it unfolds, and then you cut open the outer covering and it releases the air and it fills up. So hassle-free, ships right to your door. If you guys are interested in it, you can check the description box down below. You can actually get $150 off of your new Lull mattress.
Right across from the bed, I have my large IKEA mirror. And I mean, if you've been on YouTube long enough, you know that everyone has this mirror. It's called the Hovet, H-O-V-E-T. And I have that second of the Wayfair tables. And on top, I just have most of my jewelry. This necklace holder and the bangle holder are both from Amazon. And then the cork plate we already talked about, the ring holder also from Amazon. And I mean, my jewelry is from all over the place. And I just have a Ganapati there. On the bottom of this, I have my journals, like notebooks from fourth year clinical year. I have a notebook that I'm gonna be using for internship, and then just my pencil case. Now we're moving on to my vanity area. So I am lucky that I actually have this large windowsill space. I have this mirror that I got from IKEA. It basically like swivels, and then I have a little bit of space underneath. But I'm so lucky because I put Harriet's food and water bowl here, so she can actually look outside the window, and also having her water bowl and food bowl up something makes sure that Django can't get up to it. This main black table is also from Wayfair. On this side of the table, I have this gold wire tray that I got from Amazon, and I just have all my like daily serums, oils, moisturizers, sprays, that kind of stuff on it. And then to the left, I have this cute little succulent, and then a makeup storage thing that I'm still figuring out. I basically have all my brushes on it, and then also a candle holder that I filled with Q-tips and cotton balls and things like that. I got these two folder files, whatever it's called. These are from IKEA, but you can obviously just go to like Staples or Walmart or anything. It's just cardboard and it's meant to put binders and notebooks and paper in. But I have one for all of my hair supplies, and then the next one I have for all of my oils and refills. I put like my castor oil, jojoba, olive oil, all of my little essential oils and extra additives, so that when I run out I can just keep remaking them from under here, and it also gives them like a dark storage place to stay in. Next to the vanity, I finally bit the bullet and got myself the Alex drawers. Right on top of them, I have some extra storage. So again, this bangle holder is from Amazon. This necklace holder, I think, is from Home Goods, I believe. And then I have another makeup shelf unit, which I just have all my brushes, my eyeshadow brushes. Just want everyone to know, these are so old. You know, I haven't purchased MAC since going vegan, so those are just there because I'm not gonna throw them away. I have two of my perfumes that I use most often sitting here. Again, I got these before I was vegan. This is a little Wet n Wild perfume stick, so obviously I will start moving towards, you know, cruelty-free fragrances after these guys are finished. But that is the top of my Alex drawers. And then, I mean, my drawers are not yet entirely organized, but like, I'm trying to make use of them. So these are eyeshadows that I have, and like near the bottom I have my hair tools, and then I have like hair headbands and my brush and things like that. And now we're back to Django's crate. I just wanted to show you this picture of him I have. This is from the website Pop Your Pop. They actually liked his picture so much that they made me an extra canvas of him, which is really nice of them. So I have one storage closet here, which please beware, it's so disorganized. I have bags that I'll use for grocery shopping, and then everything else I've put into these black fabric boxes that I got from Wayfair again. And then underneath I have a whole mess of things. To the right of the vanity I have another closet. Again, not very clean at this moment, but I have hanging shelves. I have some space up there. I have my hanging clothes, my purses. So at this point we are coming into the kitchen area. So this is my seating area that we saw before. And right next to it I have Django's food water bowl, and as we move forward I actually have Harriet's litter box and litter genie right there.
Studio apartment was all fine and dandy until I took into account that I have two pets. So obviously this takes up a little bit of space, but nothing major, and you know, I'm managing. I actually still have a lot of space in the kitchen area. And once we get closer into the kitchen, I have a fridge. I have a little bit of counter space. I have a four stove, oven, microwave. I actually have a lot of cabinets, which is great for storage, as well as drawers underneath.
I have this amazing cutting board that I love, got from Christmas Tree Shop. I got these two containers to hold my oats and chia seeds from IKEA. And then over on this counter, I do have a dishwasher, which is amazing. Thank God. This here is my food cycler. I mentioned this in my last video, but I basically put all of my waste into here. And then when it fills up to that brim, I will turn it on and it turns it literally into soil. You know, just better for the environment. Bulky, but definitely worth it. If I can fit it in a studio apartment, then you guys can definitely fit it anywhere. And then next to that is my air fryer from Kasori. So, I mean, I love this thing. I cook everything in it. I no longer need a toaster oven because of it. I no longer even use an oven because of it. This basically does all my cooking for me. So I love that. And then I just have more shelves. And then this is my bathroom. So once you enter the bathroom, I mean, again, limited space. My bath mat is from IKEA. curtain is from Amazon. Here I just have my soap and two holders that have, you know, like a tongue scraper, toothbrush, and then in this little box I have Q-tips and then wipes and things like that. In my mirror, I basically have more storage. So coconut oil, because I use that as body lotion, retainer, my castor oil, hair oil mask, makeup remover, body butter, my face masks, toner. And then the shower itself is not exciting, but it does have a little indent here, which I love. So I just have my body wash, which, guys, this is cruelty free and I actually got it from Walmart and it's been really good for my skin so far. And then this is sort of a luxurious shampoo and conditioner that I have, but I love it. It has lots of essential oils in it. So that's Sol Toscana, if I said that right. And that is it, guys. That is my entire apartment. It is, again, a studio apartment in New York and I'm actually very, very, very happy with it given, you know, the size and price of it. It is so close to work, so thank God for that. And I think I'm gonna really enjoy living here. If you have any advice for me, of course, living in New York, please let me know down below. I will have everything linked, hopefully. Don't forget to like and comment down below. Subscribe if you wanna see more of my videos, and I will see you guys in my next one. Thank you.